joints on the lesson. Live in the hills, but I still get a spread. Started with a lil, but I still reinvest it. Fear how I feel, then you feel less a blessing. I just want the lesson, I just want protection. I'm up and I'm down, but they sound like progression. Farmer never plans if he waits for perfection. Finger to the down, hold it down, we gon' get it.
Hey guys, it's Uncle. Today we're gonna do Stock and Drive, part 2. But we're gonna talk about IPOs.
Okay, I'm just playing with y'all. I'm excited though. I want to bring these videos back so we could give you a little bit of the personal touch here. But we're gonna talk about the IPO today. Airbnb specifically. But the thing about Airbnb, or I guess I should say the IPOs for that matter, I have a system with it. So I want to discuss IPOs in general. We're going to go over that broadly, but then I want to talk about how we're going to trade it. So it's one thing to understand, it's one thing to trade it. The IPO is going to be coming out like December 10th or 11th, so I want to go over what my strategy is. You guys saw this with Uber. We've talked about this a lot, but I really want to give you guys understanding, and I want to show you guys the S1, the filing, and we're going to go over that. So it is going to be excited here. I'm really excited to share this with you guys. I need to go to Starbucks, and then I'm going to do this in the car so you guys get a little bit more of a personal feel, but then we're gonna go on the computer because it is gonna be a lot of reading stuff. So my chest looks bigger from this angle, but in all seriousness though, the first thing I should tell you though, you could watch this video, it will be very, very helpful, but on IPO day, we are live. We trade live Monday through Friday, 30 minutes before open. First link in the description, youtube.com/thestockmarket. So I will probably trade this IPO live. Now, if it doesn't meet my criteria, I probably won't play it. Now, that being said, I really like Airbnb stock, so I will probably scale in a little bit. If you guys remember the Snowflake IPO, we played it. We'll have some fun with it. IPO days are always fun, but I actually like this company, and I actually know a lot about it. So I want to explain to you guys this whole strategy. And I want you to know that you're blessed. You know, if anyone's going to say random like motivational stuff while you're watching stock videos, it's going to be me. So, but just know you're blessed. All right. And I hope you're excited for the end of the year. God bless you. Thank you for watching this video. Okay. So the point that I can at least talk about while we're in the car, because it's not going to require the S1. I am going to switch to the computer. I'm going to show you guys the full filing. But the thing to understand IPOs wise, this isn't how to trade it. We'll go over the criteria of what I'm looking for, but it's understanding the basics of how an IPO works. So you're going to see Airbnb. It has an IPO price of $50. Now, by the time you see it in the morning, it is probably going to be at like $80 to $100, maybe $110. I would not be surprised. You guys saw Snowflake. So a lot of you get curious what's happening. So when we read the S1, this is called the initial filing. So this is pretty much going to include the prospectus as well. Remember those two words. But this is the initial filing. They're going around saying, hey, we plan to make this much money, or we're going to offer, in this case of Airbnb, it's going to be 50 million shares. So this is going to apply directly to everything we talked about in the last driving video with float. You'll see why this is important. We'll talk about the trading strategy. But now they're going to offer, say what they're offering, how much they're going to do it for. And in that filing, they're outlining what they're going to do with the money, how much money they've made, their little pitch deck, all of that. But how this works on Wall Street, again, I'm giving you guys the Spark Notes version. I'm giving it to you really, really quickly because a lot of people like to understand this, and you'll see how regardless of this, you could still trade it and still make an investment. So that being said, now what really happens, they take that stock and they go and they do a roadshow, quote unquote, and they go around and they pitch it to banks, investors, accredited investors, people who could put up lots of money to buy large amounts of the company who would be interested. So usually this is your underwriters and banks. You will see the underwriters on the IPO. And then what do? They buy all the shares, and then come IPO day, they sell it to you, and that's where the premium comes from. So Spark Note version, if anybody would like to elaborate in the comments, you know, sometimes I'm dumb, I'm not the brightest, and YouTube is very smart. So we could source that information, but that's pretty much the broader aspect of what is happening. So that's the broad. Now let's get a little bit specific. I'm going to tell you about my IPO criteria. Now, I mean, maybe I should use this personal touch to talk about. I've been trading IPOs for a very, very long time. I've made a lot of money on them. We like to use our free share strategy. You've seen that with Snowflake, but IPOs are great. A lot of time the market has, you know, it gets a phase where it gets crazy about them and goes crazy. 2014, 2015, it was nuts. We got in a lot. 2016, 17, even 2018, there was a lot of IPOs. It wasn't that bad. And then recently, it just started going crazy again in 2020, 2019. But this is what I look for. This is my criteria. I've said this a lot. You're gonna hear me say this while we're trading live on stream when we do the IPO. The three things you need to look for is the offering size. How many shares is it offering? Understand that. And the one metric I'm looking for is for it to trade 50% of the offering, 50% of the quote unquote float. You guys learned that last week. But the idea of that is if it trades 50% of the float in the first 10 minutes, that indicates velocity. And I've usually noticed that stocks that do that or IPOs that do that usually end up having a very successful day or a very successful week. Now, none of this is a recommendation. Option trading, extremely risky. You can't lose all of your money. Don't listen. IPOs are the riskiest stock you could buy. They haven't been proven. This is their first day out. And even like Uber, sometimes you want to give them like 2 or 3 years in the league to kind of prove themselves. And that's kind of like, you know, NBA athletes, college, all that. But the general concept is if it trades 50% of that float in the first 10 minutes, that's one a good sign. If I see that, usually I start scaling in. Next, if it ends up trading the whole float, that's very, very good. Again, I love IPOs because it's just pure supply and demand. So when you have pure supply and demand, it becomes very, very easy to see, okay, what, you know, supply and demand determines price. So if you have all the shares traded, there's a lot of demand, shares are trading hands, and it's going to do so at a higher and higher price. Some people are going to hold, so on and so forth. It's going to go from there. So the first aspect I'm really looking for is the offering size and how much does indeed get traded in the first 10 minutes and then by the end of the day. The next thing you need to look for is going to be how much above the offering is the stock going for. So Airbnb is priced at $50. Like I'm saying, by the time you guys wake up in the morning, by the time the IPO comes out, and it'll probably come out about anywhere from 8:30 to like 10:30, so about 2 to 3.5 hours after market opens, you might see the IPO. But the question is, how much above the offering does it come out? So if it has a high premium baked in, so if it's at 50 and it opens up at like 150, 200, I would be inclined to not play it. But after seeing stuff like Snowflake, the FOMO, the market's crazy, the bubble, everything's a bubble, I don't know what I would do in that case, but usually that's a negative sign. So if you see that it has a lot of demand and it's not pricing too much of a premium, that's a good sign. But I'll tell you a bad sign, some IPOs don't meet the offering. So when they go and try to pitch it to all the banks, you know, Airbnb's coming at 50, some companies, there's not that much demand. So if you see a company that doesn't meet its offering price, I usually won't touch it. I'll stay far away from that. Because if the banks won't buy it, hoping to flip it to retail, the secondary market, that means something's up with it. I don't like that. The next factor is just simply gonna be about scaling in now. So if you know those first two things, if you could understand the velocity, the supply and demand, understand how that thing is getting valued, understand how it's pricing, and then the premium, the next question is using increments of 50, 100, or whatever your amount is. What I like to do is once it hits that 10 minute mark, if it has that, I buy it. If off the bat it doesn't have the premium associated with it or it's not too much, I will start scaling in. And that's what I do is every single hour or so now, I will start to buy, you know, 50, 100 shares. Again, it all depends on the budget, but one of the best ways to scale is literally just little by little, one at a time. That is what I end up doing all the time, and it ends up working. Or at the very least, it gives you some flexibility to do what you need to do. Okay, so I'm gonna jump to the computer. I don't wanna keep ranting on this, and we'll kind of get into the more trading strategy again. You'll see it live if anything, but I wanna show you the filing. But as an interlude, this is your birthday cake pop. The infamous one we've talked about. I got a pineapple matcha too, if you want to try that. I don't know, but okay, get ready. I love you. God bless you.
So to the computer now, this is the Airbnb S1. The S1 is the registration statement. This is where it has the prospectus and all of the information. So if you guys really want to get into IPOs, and even this week with the Airbnb IPO, I think there's going to be DoorDash as well, and then like an AI company. This is where you get all of the information, and this is how the company files with the SEC, the government, the NASDAQ, whatever you want to call it. But the idea of this, it has a few parts, and this is what I want to highlight with you. Obviously, shares are going to be important, and you'll notice this is a S1A. So A means addended, means they added to it. So they filed one of these months ago. As the roadshow goes on, as they start to do stuff, you get more and more information, and then this gets filled out. So if you go look at an earlier S1, the amount of shares registered will not be there, the price will not be there, and a lot of this really will just be different. But as the dates come closer to IPO, as they get more information, they start soliciting the investments, all of that, it then becomes addended. They then add to it, and then you start to get the full picture. So here's the Airbnb IPO, 56.9 million shares to be registered at an offering price of $50, and then they're going to be making about $2.8 billion. That's how much they are raising. So This is important. $56 million is going to be the number. Now we will get into it. So they're going to explain stuff, and this is how every IPO works. This is going to be their prospectus. And now I like reading these. I think they're always fun. It's like telling a story. See, in the beginning, two friends opened their door. Brian and Joe are first hosts. Now we have a bunch of Brian and Joes that replicate. I don't even know. But it's pretty much giving you their story. It's honestly great to read. You get to go see it. They're explaining, hey, this is our company. This is our history. What happened? What we've done? And then explaining, you know, the key factors of their business. So this is important because this is how investors know about the company. Now think about what we said. This is what they're doing on the roadshow. They're going bank to bank, company to company, explaining all of this stuff. And now, especially with COVID, one of the big things they're doing, and you'll even see it here on their filing, they're even explaining what happened in COVID and showing you month by month to say, hey, this is how we got affected. This is what's going on and so forth. But coming back up to here, you'll see it's bulleted. They're explaining again more about what they do, what they plan to do, the host, how they make money, all of that. So I encourage you to go over this. Again, I like Airbnb as a company. I'm going over this so you guys could go and do your own due diligence so you learn where to get it, kind of how to interpret it. And even then, like we already discussed, there is the trading aspect as well with it. So it's explaining all of that stuff, their strength. It will go with risk factors, all that. Then you get into the balance sheet. But this is where it really, really gets good. I would read risk factors on a lot of them. But the main thing I'm looking for usually is the offering. So back to float in shares. It's saying this is how many shares we're offering, how many shares of additional shares they're going to be offering to the market maker. So it says 50 million shares offered with an additional 5 million. And then you got 1.9 being sold by additional shareholders. That's where your 56 million shares from above comes into play. So this is an option exercise because the banks that are doing the IPO, what they do is they get a little option just in case to buy more shares to facilitate orderly trading. Again, when the bank starts selling it on the morning of IPO, their job is to do orderly trading. If you want to see a mishap of orderly trading, go look at Facebook's IPO, believe it or not. Facebook was a great company. I love that company. You guys know, you know Facebook. But if you go look on their IPO date, it was actually a mess and it didn't have orderly trading and it led to even the stock getting clobbered. But this is what you really want to look. And now, you know, we could get into this when we start talking about shares, and I'm sure I'll probably make another video, but there's different types of shares that they're offering. So it's saying how many shares they want to sell to the public. This is essentially going to be the float, the additional shares that will be added to the float through the market makers or the underwriters, the shares being sold by selling stockholders. So that's like if the CEO or some of the employees, they're like, well, I want to take some profits. I have available shares. I'm willing to offer those up in the IPO. You have an idea of how much is being sold. And now it's saying class A stock to be outstanding after this offering. So notice they're offering 50 million, but why will there be 98 million? Because other shares existed. Other people were holding stock. And then now you get into the different types of shares. There's going to be class B shares. That's another 488 million. There's going to be no class C, and then there's going to be class H. And then if you actually read into Airbnb's IPO, they're setting up the class H 9 million shares as an endowment fund to even protect the host. So that gets kind of into the model. It's really, really good, I think, even for the ride sharing model. But just from a supply and demand perspective, you just want to know the underlying fundamental structure of shares. And this is one of the most important things to any IPO, in my opinion. So now they're telling you right now, 50 million is going to be your float because this is what they're selling to the public. There's going to be another 48 million shares held by other people that will still be outstanding. These are floated because they're being traded. Outstanding means other people are holding them. They're outstanding. And then now total after all of this, when you factor in all of the other shares, it's saying there's going to be a total of 596 million shares. Or 601 million if the underwriters exercise their option to purchase that 5 million. So now this is even explaining the difference between the shares. And this is where it gets important because, and again, you need to do your own due diligence. We will go over this. If you have any questions, we will get into this. Investopedia will help you understanding share classes and all that. But even then, the company is saying what each share represents. It's saying, what's the difference between A, B, C, and H? How much voting rights do you get with Class A? Class B gets 20 rights, so on and so forth. So read that. And then it's even telling you, hey, Holders of our outstanding Class B will beneficially own 80% of our outstanding capital stock and hold 99% of the voting power, kind of like Snapchat. So it explains that. Again, I could talk about this for a while, but it gets a little complex. But the idea is, be aware of the numbers, be aware of the shares that are outstanding. Next, that's important with these filings or in the prospectus, is going to be the use of proceeds. It's telling you what they want to do. So they're saying, we're going public, we're offering, you know, 50 million shares. Clearly, there's going to be like 596 million other shares. What do they plan to do with this money? Why are they going public with this portion? And what do they plan to do with it? What do they want to spend the money on? So they're saying general corporate purposes, working capital, all that. Depending on the company, they may have different plans that could relate to profitability or the growth of the company. So they're explaining more and more, and then they go in the risk factors and all that. But as you go through here, and again, I would even read more, just anything with shares, RSUs, Class A. This is telling you about all those hundred millions of shares outstanding and how they get vested, the prices they're at. You know, say Class A common stock, people got granted stocks, stock options with a price of $39.04. You could read these and get an idea even of how the company has even valued its own shares to its employees, the incentives, what would the CEOs have incentivized, what would that mean for the stock price, all of that. But these are the most important parts. We could get into the financials and all that. Let me know if you want that. I might save that for the next video. But the main thing you guys need to know about here with this is the offering, and then, like we said, how to trade it. So to recap and to give it to you at the end, now that we kind of have an idea, hey, it's going to be a 50 million share float or 56 million. I do like to include the underwriter option. I'm assuming that is going to get sold. So what are we looking for on IPO date? How am I planning to trade this? Really, in the first 10 minutes, if I see over about what, 26 million shares traded in that first 10 minutes, or like 25 million or so, I'm going to do one scale in and probably get 100 shares, maybe 200 shares. If it doesn't price above 100%, in the morning, I might even get 100 shares in the first minute. That first scale in will depend on, again, the opening price. And then after that first 10 minutes, if it does, again, meet that criteria, I will scale in with another 100 shares. And then I will wait for the whole float to turn. I will wait for around 50, 56 million in volume. And if it does have that, and depending on where the price is, another 100 shares in hold. And then in the future, hopefully, I may want to go bigger on this. But lately with IPOs and the premiums, I know this one's going to have a premium. I'm probably not going to go crazy on it. But the best case scenario would be you hold these IPOs, it goes crazy on IPO day, we're able to sell, get our initial investment back, and boom, we got some free IPO shares, baby. But that is pretty much it. I hope this helps. I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend. I hope we see you on stream for the Airbnb IPO. If you guys have any questions, if I could elaborate on this in any way, please let me know, and I appreciate all of you, and let's go, baby.